What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I am going to be showing you how to model this cool building. So it looks like a museum or something, and I like the loft that forms in between these the bottom and the top of the building, and I'm just going to be showing you how you model something like that inside of Revit. Now, I got this idea from the How to Rhino YouTube channel, and he got the idea from, I think it was an Instagram page of Arky Hub. I hope I have pronounced that right. And now I'm just going to be showing you how to model something like that inside of Revit. Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There I have many courses on many different topics inside of Revit, and one of the topics, for example, is conceptual massing inside of Revit, how to create all sorts of complex forms inside of Revit, and also I have a very interesting course on adaptive components inside of Revit that can create this shape or this type of shape a lot more parametrically, so you can make some changes and it's just going to make it a bit easier. In this video, I'm just going to be showing you how kind of the basic approach. And also on my website, you can find many other things, so make sure to check it out. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here we are in Revit. I'm at the home page. So I'm just going to go to here to models. I'm going to go to new. And then for the template file, I'm going to choose the architecture design template. Now, this is one of the templates that's available on my website. So if you want to check that out, I'm also going to be leaving a link to that in the description of this video and then also up in the cards above. Anyways, now let's click OK and let's let Revit start right up. Okay, so as soon as Revit starts up, I'm going to be modeling this as in massing inside. But first, this is just the start page. So let's go to the level one floor plan, for example, get rid of that start page. And now let's get started. So go to massing inside, go to show mass first, just to make sure it's visible. And then let's go to in place mass. We can leave a name as is. So mass one, that's perfectly fine. And now let's place some reference planes first. So I'm just going to go here to plane, and then I'm just going to place one horizontal plane like this, one horizontal plane here, and then one here. Now, I'm not going to worry about scaling too much, just because this is kind of a playful project. I'm not going to go too much into scale. So yeah, let's go like this, like 10,000 centimeters, or is it 1,000? Yeah, 1,000 centimeters in between these, and then also make sure to name these. So you just click here to name the reference plane. This one is going to be number one, this one is going to be number two, and then this one is going to be number three. Okay, so once we have these placed, then what I'm going to do is go to one of the elevations. Now, you can go either to the east or west. I started numbering from here, so I'm just going to go to the west elevation. And then I'm just going to create a rectangle here on the bottom. But first, we have to specify the work plane. And for that, I'm going to specify that by name and then just go with reference plane number one. That's the one that we have created. So, oops, number one. Okay, and now let's click OK. And now we can get started. So let's start off on the bottom here. So I'm just going to create it like so. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then let's go into level one. Sorry, let's go into the 3D view. Okay, so this is what we have, and then level one looks like that. Okay, I think the size is fine. So let's go back now into the west elevation and let's modify this a little bit. So I want to add a spline here just so we have that kind of angular shape. So we're creating kind of the bottom of this thing. So let's go here to the spline, to this spline tool. So just a regular spline, not the spline through points. And then let's go like this. Make sure you're here drawing a work plane and make sure that the reference plane is the number one. And then you want to click once here. Now, don't click on the line. Click a little bit below. And then for the last click, or let's do another one here. And then the last click is going to be here. hit the escape key a couple of times, and then you can modify this line by highlighting it, so hovering over that, hitting the tab key once or twice to select it, and then you can move these little grip points in order to adjust it. So let's say I'm happy with this positioning here. Okay, so once I have this thing in place like this, I'm going to highlight the top one, hit the tab key a couple of times to select just the top line, and then delete that. And then I'm going to drop this line down here. Okay, looks perfectly fine now. Okay, now let's select the whole loop of lines that we have, and then you want to copy it to the other reference planes. Now you can just use the copy tool, but what I prefer to do is to select it, then I like to go here to copy to clipboard, paste, and then align to the same place. So we have just basically duplicated this shape here. Now it's still selected, so what we can do is we can go here to host and change it from reference plane 1 to reference plane 2. And now as you can see, it's copied here. And then I can do the same thing again. So paste, align to the same place, and then just change the host of the new one to reference plane 3. See how cool that is? Okay, now let's just make some changes here. So actually here, I might want to move this up a little bit, just like that. And then for this one, I'm just going to select this point here. Let's see. It's kind of hard. You have to select the spline first and then use the tab key to select the point here. Okay, something like that. And then this one I want to bring down a little bit, not too much. Kind of like that. Yeah, we can do it like that. Okay, and then this line I want to extend up, and then this line I want to extend down. Okay, so that's what we want to see. And then finally, let's go to this side. So again, use the tab key a few times to just select the top spline. Then use the tab key to just drag this line end, and then you want to drag it down to level 1. And then this one we want to drag way up. Something like that. Okay. Let's see. Yeah. Looks good. Okay. And then we just want to play around with these. So just adjust it here, and then adjust this here. Okay. So once we have all three of these in place, next I'm just going to select all three of them, and then I'm going to go to my west elevation, and then I'm just going to go here to mirror, pick axis, and then pick this axis here. So I've just mirrored that up. See? And that's what they wanted to do. And then you can just bring this down a little bit by using the tab keys, using the arrow keys, and then this is what we have in the end. Perfect. Okay, so once you're happy with your shape, what you want to do then is just select, kind of try to orbit around so you can select all three top ones, just like that, and then you go to create form. And then you want to select all three bottom ones, and then orbit around, and then go to create form. Okay, perfect. And now I just want to cut off the bottom of the bottom, so to speak, so it's kind of flat with the level 1. So I'm just going to go to the west elevation and then create a rectangle down on level 1, go back to the 3D view, select that rectangle and make it a void. You want to extend it all the way out, click, and now as you can see, it's cutting through there. Okay, so now we have kind of the top and the bottom, and now it's time to create our blend shapes. So for that, what I'm going to do is just hit finish here, and then I'm going to go into level 1 and just run a quick section through this thing. So just like that. Maybe move it to the inside a little bit. Perfect. Okay, now let's go back to level 1. Let's select the shape and go to edit in place. Then you want to add a reference plane here just in front of that section. So just in front of it, like so. Okay, and let's call this one reference plane A. Okay, and now we can open up before we open this up, let's go here to circle. It's going to be on level 1, that's perfectly fine. Make sure it says draw on work plane, and then you just want to select and click here on the reference plane and create a circle. And let's create a circle like that big. Okay, perfect. Now we can select that circle, we can go to our not the west elevation. I actually want to go into that section, so let's find it here. Okay, section 1. Perfect. So we have that circle here. Okay, now I want to copy that circle, so let's just go here to copy, unconstrain that, and then let's just copy it up here, for example. Move it perhaps off to the side a little bit. Okay, so we have a circle on the bottom, and then we have a circle on the top. Now, for this one on the top, we can actually resize it if we want. So, for example, I can make this one a bit smaller, so then I can say, okay, this one is going to be 150. Okay, so once we have these two, I can go back into my section, and then I can go to Align, and then make sure it's your drawing on that reference plane A. And then I'm just going to connect the center of this circle here with the center of this circle here, just so I can have a path for my my loft shape. Okay, then we want to select this circle here that we have on the bottom, go to copy, and then make sure you unconstrain that and make sure that multiple is selected, and then you just want to copy that multiple times on this line. And then one more here. Okay, then you want to go to the 3D view and you want to make the center one really small. So let's go with like 50, 40. And then this one is going to be a bit larger. So let's go with, I don't know, like 90. Let's see, maybe even 80 will work. And then this one, let's make this one 100 perhaps, and then let's see what this looks like. So you just want to hold the control key and select all 5 of these circles and then go to create form. So it's going to create, yeah, there we go, we have that form that we wanted. Okay, and then when we have this form, we can just go to join geometry, join the bottom with this, and then join the whole thing with this, and it's going to create that perfect lofted shape. Hit the escape key a couple of times, and then we can delete the line in the middle. It was only there to help us orient our circles. And then you can basically repeat that process of creating a section and then creating a reference plane and creating multiple of these lofts along this shape. And I'm actually just going to be making a few more of these just to make it look interesting, and then we're going to be completing this video. And as you can see, this is what I have done. So I have just played around a little bit more. I have copied a few of these reference planes, and then I have kind of moved my section so I can model each one of these. And this is what we have. Now, just to finalize this as a kind of a conceptual 3D model, I'm going to select the whole thing by using the Tab key. And then I'm just going to add a material here. Let's just use gypsum wallboard, for example. So just something kind of white conceptual. And then let's switch this to realistic. There we go. It looks really nice. And then let's add some color in the middle. So I'm just going to go to my manage tab. Let's go to materials. Here, I think I have a yellow, a yellow parking stripe material. But what I don't like is that it's a bit too yellow, so I just want to make it a little bit orangish, just like that, and then let's use that same thing here for render appearance. Okay, and now I can go to my modify tab, and then here we should have a paint tool. There we go, and then let's use that parking stripe. Let's see, there we go. So we can just kind of apply that material everywhere here on these elements just to finalize our conceptual 3D model of this thing. And as you can see, this is what we have in the end. I think it looks really good. You can create some really nice views of this thing, and I think this was a kind of a cool little exercise. If you want to get this project file, you can actually find it on my Patreon page. I'm going to be including a link to it just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit project files. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe, for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.